Typical of last season. Get the job done, efficient. You're talking about entertainment value. Not great, but 3 points on the board.
Are you a little frustrated that if your boys had had a go or been more incisive in and around the box, there was more there for them?
Yeah, I think so. I think on reflection, that they'll be slightly disappointed that they didn't actually carve out a few more openings. They had a fair percentage of the game in terms of possession. Just looked a little bit short up front. Yeah, and actually did okay there. But you were waiting, or you thought if Vardy came on, or if Vardy had played from the start, maybe a few more things might have happened. So that proved to be the case.
If Leicester go away from Old Trafford disappointed, mm-hmm. they didn't take something with them, what does that say about the home side?
I'm reluctant to be too critical opening day and with what's happened in pre-season and after a World Cup. I think we might get a couple of performances like this for certain teams that have not had all the players back, Richard. So I'm a little bit reluctant to be overly critical of United. I thought they passed it poorly. What I would say, there's no excuse for not passing the ball to your teammates. I thought the retention of the football wasn't very good at all. I thought they could have done much, much better with that. But I think they'll get better. They have to get better, because that standard is not going to be good enough to take them anywhere near the title. That's for sure. They were second in most departments. Fewer shots in goal than Leicester. Less possession than Leicester. We're talking about Manchester United at Old Trafford mm-hmm. on the opening day, when you would have thought they were right up for it. But they weren't. So I think in a month's time, we'll get more of an idea where this United side are.
Mourinho celebrated the win with his staff, Peter, like he'd won the cup. Mm. Is that saying more about the problems he feels he had, or maybe those he created pre-season, about the win?
I think there's a lot of frustration there. A lot of frustration in the transfer market. And it's a release. We look at Jose and he's a great coach, but he's a human being, has feelings, and I think that was it. And just something Matt said before, I think if Vardy had gone on there earlier or started, I think Leicester would have put balls in the box, because I thought possession, they were all right, but it was always in front of Manchester United till Vardy come on. And then, by the way, he volleyed one over when he should have scored. But once, if you put balls in the danger area, defenders have got to deal with it. But if you've got a striker on the move, it's hard to do it. And Leicester looked a threat when he put the ball in the box and Vardy was on the pitch.
And Manchester United really could not have had a better start, could they? Penalty award inside 1:20.
No, that's right. And you thought at that stage, you know, Leicester was scrambling a little bit. Shaw breaking down the left-hand side. Amati getting caught out initially, out of position, and then inexplicably, really, raises his arm. Instinctive reaction that we mentioned at half-time. And all of a sudden, Leicester on the back foot. And you would think Man United would be very much on the front. And, you know, looking to sort of ram home that advantage that they'd created in the early stages. But after that, it just...
And it's a penalty. Stupid.
It's a penalty.
There's no argument about that one.
But they were getting bodies forward. They were closing Leicester down. Leicester looked rattled. OK, you don't expect that for 90 minutes, but we're going to force the issue for the next 10, 15, 20 minutes.
I thought for 20 minutes. They should have driven the game forward, without a doubt. You've got a goal start, and I thought, at home, there's been a lot of negativity around. Here they had a little, not an argument, it was a discussion more than anything. He definitely wanted it, Alexis Sanchez. He definitely wanted to take the penalty. Pogba said, I'm captain, I'm going to take it. He eventually gets to the ball, trust me. That must be the slowest run-up I've ever seen. But after that, I just thought the natural thing would be to get on the front foot, to really get on the front foot. But the opposite happened. They backed away at the halfway line every time Leicester got possession and allowed Leicester to settle into the game. And Leicester were really neat and tidy with the football. I agree with Matt. I thought if they had more cutting edge
they could have been given the chance to settle into the game. Mm. You know, look, 1-0 down, away at Old Trafford, first couple of minutes, penalty, a bit shaky. Man, you could have possibly gone and finished the game off early on,
We'll talk more in just a moment, but Sir Paul Pogba has come out to talk to us. It seems like a very good time to go and hear what he has to say. Which leaves you wondering where and with whom he wants to do all of those things. He didn't quite ask the question, Jeff, did he? But was edging towards it. For a coach who's made a reputation of dealing with the minutest of detail. Does it surprise you to hear that they don't have a designated penalty taker?
Not really, because a team like Manchester United should have enough footballers on the pitch who are good enough to take a penalty. And I guess, as he said there, it depends how you feel. If they got a penalty in the last 5 minutes and you were the designated penalty taker and you had been having a nightmare of a game, you might not want to take it.
I tend to disagree with that. Yeah. I like my teams to have a penalty taker because there's been a few incidents where people, I mean, they had a little discussion, mm-hmm. but where they're dragging the ball off each other. And I don't think it bodes well. And then, if they're arguing, I think it puts extra pressure. Maybe not that one. But my point is, if you have a designated penalty taker, no argument, gets the ball down, and he takes it.
You used to take them, Matt, didn't you?
I did. I used to hammer a few, shut my eyes, down the middle, wait for the keeper to dive.
But it was always your
responsibility. I did it long before it was invented, you know. That wait for the keeper to smash it down the middle. But, I mean... Ordinarily, there's a designated taker. That taker can always, to go on the back of your point, can always say no. But initially, if he wants it, it does.
Who would they have had on the pitch?
Make things clearer. Than
probably no one in the back four would have taken one. They probably have got Pogba.
I have to say, if I was looking at that team sheet prior to the start, I would have said Sanchez.
Yeah, I would have too.
I would have said Sanchez.
He's probably more regular,
United,
isn't he?
He's missed for United, didn't he, last year? Sure he did. Mm.
I thought it was a bit of a strange game. Listen, Claude Puel goes there, Manchester United, all the problems they've had in the summer, let's keep it tight, lads. For 20 minutes, if we keep it tight, it'll be like this run-up's unbelievable, isn't it?
He knows, though. The thing I liked about his interview there, he knows if he does a run-up like that, he's got to score. Because if he doesn't, he's going to get criticised.
What a start that is, then, for Manchester United. Leicester's game plan's gone out the way, keep it tight. And then, like we said before, I'm expecting Manchester United, with that start at Old Trafford, to get after.
But it took the best part of another hour. Mm-hmm. It took a fullback with whom Mourinho has had a very fractious relationship for them to stretch the lead.
Again, I think he's in a fractious relationship because he knows he's not been fit enough and he knows he's better than what he's shown United so far, I think. Now, whether he'll stay in the team is another debate, Luke Shaw. You know, that's what we wait when Ashley Young has decided he's fit enough. And fairness to him, he reacted really, really well. It wasn't a great first touch. And, you know, you might want to criticise Pereira for not reacting quick enough, but I think Shaw reacts really quick. And what I liked about this move is young McTominay, he could have taken the easy ball and played it wide, right, and he slid it straight to Mata, who was in the most central area, who was able to play that pass. I think he just reacts quicker. And it's a really good finish.
Dennis Bergkamp at Newcastle?
Unintentional, though, wasn't it, as well? And he mentions Pereira there. It's good switch play by Man United. Good run forward from Shaw at that stage of the game. You know, maybe answering questions about his fitness. But Pereira's... One, he reacted too late. He was too narrow initially. And then he was rushing at the ball as Shaw's had the touch. He's got to be there and set and ready to turn. He wasn't. Shaw's had he's miscontrolled it basically. How he's able to get round the other side of the defender and still not just get
this
the ball
here,
actually
like,
get
this
a
is
shot
the one I'm talking about.
Well.
That ball, he could have gone wide, and he kept it central.
Tommy's a decent player. He hasn't. He's meant to go more central, hasn't he? There, defenders moving forward, so can't spin. Should be stronger as well. Yeah. Shaw's quite robust. He's done well to hook it in the far corner.
I'm pleased with him, Luke Shaw, because he's had a bad time and the manager has got after him. And great response for the boy there.
You enjoyed Leicester's goal, didn't you? Why?
Why? Because they stuck a cross in. Because they put it in the danger area. I'm all for possession football, but sometimes you've got to ask the question of defenders. And he comes in. Look, he's not picking anyone out. He's sticking it in an area and it comes back off the post. Maybe a bit of luck. But what I'm saying, he's putting pressure on defenders here and the goalkeeper to do something. They don't deal with it. Yeah. It's in the back of the net. And by the way, there was a chance earlier on, just before that, where Vardy's hit one over. And listen, I'm not on about just getting the ball and hitting willy-nilly balls all the time. But sometimes, ask the question.
I have been used... down the years, from the time that you played for Martin O'Neill to watching a Leicester team that were very smash and grab, and they won a title like that. Is Puel creating a team that are nice?
They could be accused of that, a little bit lightweight, maybe, in certain areas. But I thought generally tonight, they got the mix just about right, really. But it's more really? It's more technically based, I think.
Yeah, you know, they're softer on
that. Yeah, I think so.
And is that softness going to take away the strength that Leicester have always had, which has been to get in your face, which has been to break on you? As they did when they ripped Manchester United apart.
Jamie Vardy's been a large part of that. Yeah. Didn't feature for the best part of an hour, I think just over an hour, wasn't it? He does give them that aggressive edge. He gets the defenders on their toes. Mm. Iheanacho, not quite the same sort of player. Not the same sort of aggressiveness about him. Yeah, nice. I know what you're saying, a little bit lightweight. Maybe,
I think when I watched the
Indeed, he gets stuck in there in midfield, sorry. But
no.
Yeah, he makes his fair share of challenges, quite physical and robust, but certainly Puel has taken them in a different direction. You've got to find a blend of the two.
You played Leicester, you were part of it. You knew what you were going to get, which was a...
Oh, we're going back a few years.
Well, yes, but that tradition continued through, didn't it?
Well, it does. It did continue through. Even in the title-winning season, they were very much in your face at times, Leicester, and they were very much a counter-attacking side.
Yeah. I was just going to mention that title.
Right now, what Puel's done for me is very rarely when they won the title did I see Kasper Schmeichel roll it out to the two centre-backs. Very rarely, if ever. Mm. But now you watch Leicester and they will roll it out to the full-back. The interesting for me is where they go. They bought Johnny Evans in, who I think is a decent footballer. He likes to get on the ball. He doesn't get embarrassed by it. And I think Big Wes might find himself under a little bit of pressure if Puel wants to go along that line. Because they've got one in Maguire, who's comfortable with it. If they want another one like that and Johnny Evans, then I think Wes might have a problem staying in that side if he's going to keep letting them play from the back. Now, that might improve them as a team, but I don't know if it'll be as effective with Jamie Vardy in the side playing that way. Because, the longer they take to get him in the game, the less space there is for him to run into. It's a natural thing. And it's like United tonight. You know, if Vardy had played from the front, they'd have backed off still. They'd have kept backing off and not allowing the space in behind for him to go into.
It's like when I watched Leicester win the title, I watched them at Goodison Park, you won 3-1. Great on the counter-attack. Yeah. 2 weeks later was at Manchester City.
Yeah.
3-1 again on counter-attack. I dare bet Leicester had more possession than Manchester United tonight.
Yeah, today you did.
Did they?
And that never happened the year they won the title.
So what I'm saying, it's a different... I mean, Manchester United, Leicester have had more possession at Old Trafford. It's unbelievable. When they won it, they had Mahrez, Vardy, all Brighton. They had people who could get at them on the counter-attack, solid at the back.
Yeah.
Kante in there, drink water in
Kante
there.
And drink water.
Solid as anything. Yeah. This is a different one.
So is he creating, in softening it, a more effective team?
Well, I don't think they'll be as effective as the title-winning team, no. And some way short, really, because, you know, that was a monumental achievement and everything just gelled together at the right time. Mm. And like most things, I think, you know, certainly in a football sense, you need to find a blend. You know, it's not about playing. If you play one way and one way only, teams will find you out. I think you have to.
They didn't in the championship winning season.
Yeah, I'm contradicting myself there.
No, but they lost some good players, didn't they? They lost Kante.
Yeah, different players.
You know, if you lose some your good players
going back to the title winning season, I think there was a touch of arrogance from teams because they should have worked them out.
Yeah.
And I think they thought they can't keep doing this. It's only Leicester. Yeah. We'll try and play our way out again, and they kept getting caught. And
I think
no one
Leicester, I think what we've got to remember with Leicester brought in what seven players.
Around about that, seven, eight players.
Of course, the best part of £100 million, right? That's a lot of investment. So we only saw two of them tonight for part of that game. So I think there is more to come. There is more involvement from Leicester and from Puel and what he wants his side to do and who he wants to be in his side, because they haven't spent £100 million on players not to play, most of them, I wouldn't have thought. So it'll be interesting to see where they go from here now. Once everyone gets in, after this first break coming up, what have we got, 4 weeks?
Sorry, again to interrupt, I keep doing it tonight, but Claude Puel is waiting to talk to us. He's with BeIN Sports' Matt Critchley.